Thank you so much for joining us and welcome to Viewpoints Saturday. And I am Shegun Olabi. Viewpoints is a news and current affairs program and airs on this station every Saturday, 8:15 a.m. For some time now, River State has been on the news for the reasons. There have been reports of killing, there have been reports of verbal attacks on radio, and there have been allegations and counter-allegations. This morning on Viewpoints, we have with us in the studio the immediate past governor of River State and the present Minister of Transportation, Federal Republic of Nigeria. And joining us this morning, we have Right Honorable Chibuike Rotimi Amaechi on Viewpoints. Your Excellency, good morning and thank you so much for joining us on Viewpoint.
Good morning.
And it's so good to have you after some time, sir.
Thank you very much.
Now, of course, you can participate on this show, and we have quite a whole lot of numbers for you to call to participate on the show. For those calling us, you can call us on 08147461263. That is 08147461263. 08147461263. Or you call us on 0909-6264-639. 0909-6264-639. And for our female callers, you can call 0909-5428-778. 0909-5428-778. You can also send us a short text message to 0803-3386-571 or follow us on WhatsApp on the numbers 0803-3386-571. We're also available on Facebook, and on Facebook, please follow us on Viewpoint PH and on Twitter, hashtag Amaechi. Well, we're going to be focusing on River State, the political situation in River State, and also what His Excellency Right Honorable Chibuike Rotimi Amaechi is doing in assisting River State, particularly in the area of transportation. Once again, thank you so much for joining us, Your Excellency. Your Excellency, it was since you left us for Abuja, this is about the second time or third time, if I'm right, that you are coming to Port Harcourt. Tell us, what's your view of River State that you left behind and what we have now?
You know, when you said this is the third time, I felt I should give both the governor and the people of River State an opportunity to be governed and feel the impact of a new government. I didn't want to interfere with any activity by anybody. So it was necessary to keep away. However, I've been back to this state for the three occasions that I've been to this state. If I tell you, I'm not disappointed. All the primary schools I thought we built to standard are abandoned. Poor children we sent overseas. He said they I sent them to go and study economics and law.
No English.
It's ridiculous. There are medical students in a school in Ireland. They've been sent back. Final year students. Mm. In Norway, the Norwegian government called the federal government to say that why are we withdrawing our students? And the school fees was cheap. Medical students. In Germany, medical students. In Canada, medical students. You know, the problem we have is people, yesterday I tried to differentiate, as I was taught in the University of Port Harcourt, there's a difference between being literate and being non-literate, and being non-literate and being illiterate. Non-literate is someone who didn't go to school. Illiterate is somebody who went to school but is a bushman, is a village man, who doesn't know the importance of school. I think the governor of this state is an illiterate. He may be literate.
Isn't that attacking the person?
No, let me tell you why I say so.
Yeah.
If you appreciate the importance of education, you can borrow. He's been borrowing money. Mm-hmm. He's borrowed. My first year in office, I never borrowed any. The total indebtedness of the state when I came in was high. I borrowed about 300 billion. By the time I was leaving, I left behind just 17 billion naira. But the man is everywhere lying. So if he was literate, won't just be illiterate, he would know that it is important, whether those people are children of his enemies, to pay their school fees and return them to River State. Because at the end of the day, they will become doctors, they will train patients.
But the governor has said that River State does not have money. He was here last week and he told us that the internally generated revenue is nosediving
because of
5
what
billion.
Because of what he did. When I was here, the revenue rose from 2.5. I measured at 2.5. I raised it to 6.8. Got to 9 billion. I never increased tax, never introduced new tax. never shut people's offices or people's businesses. I never brought Obiagbo into reverse government. Not the Obiagbo thing, I mean, that is where you have this Obiagbo house, go block road, block people's offices, harass people. No way. I made it modern. Every year you go and pay your tax. You are written to, you are told the account, you pay. But now we have total, it's behaving like a chairman of local government, where people are harassed, they are shut down, they are abused. Every day he's abusing people, closing people's offices. Why would they run away? People are running away from the state. That is why the revenue is nosedive. How do I know where there's insecurity situation? I check my revenue. If my revenue is going down, there's indication that there's a problem. So what do? I begin to ask, where is this problem coming from? If it's insecurity, I tackle this insecurity to encourage businessmen. Now, I'm no longer governor of Rivers State. Every day I receive calls from oil companies, from embassies. What do we do? I say, I can't do anything. They have a governor. Let him govern.
But you see, you also have been blamed to be part of the problem. I'm going to quote a statement issued by the River State Commissioner for Information and Communication, Dr. Austin Tam George, at a press conference in January on the 28th. He said, Amaechi left the most abandoned project in the history of River State since 1997. And it insinuated that this government is trying to put in place this abandoned project.
You should name the abandoned projects. Tell him to name the abandoned projects. I had 750 primary schools. I promised the state that I will build. I completed 500. He should come. Let's verify that. The abandoned projects he will call will be the road starting from the end of Transamade to east. Well, to build it to East West Road, but to Abaju.
Actually, there's the Woji Road project, which is said to be.
That's that one. That's what I'm calling. What I'm calling. Is it how much?
3 billion.
Okay, wait, that's what I'm talking about. Maybe what was left was 3 billion, but that project was about 16. Now, can you complete 2 bridges in 2 years? Can you, if you say it's abandoned? What was remaining was about 4 spans to complete the second bridge. The first bridge was completed, the second bridge was about 4 spans. If they commissioned it less than 4 to 6 months in of stay in office, was that an abandoned project? If they commissioned that project 4 to 6 months in office, was that an abandoned project? That site was active, but don't forget, by the time we were leaving, we were struggling to pay salaries. And again, he claimed that I was owing 12 months salaries. I never owed. I assured workers, one thing I will not do, instead the projects will not be paid for, is to owe you salaries. We are paying a press salary when we left office. But Nyesom Wike is everywhere lying. A governor who lies is deceiving his people. You know, one thing he does is, why are not people asking to provide evidence? We went to the new city. We are working at the new city. The contractors are on site. Is that an abandoned project? First, let Nyesom Wike tell us one project he has completed. Let him tell us. By this time, last time I was governor, I had completed projects. I was on the streets. I was not shouting. The odilis were fighting me in court. I never abused them one day. I would have accused Dr. Dili, he stole money, he didn't steal money. I was rather focusing on the things to do. This is your road. Who did it? No, don't shake your head. This is your road. Who did it? Our government. It wasn't like this. The one after your road, who did it? Rivers State government. The one after that to government house, who did it? We have, there is no way Yesu will, you see, it's like you wake up, I won't call the governor, one of the military governors woke up and said, everywhere I go, speak, I won't bother about speak again. That's what Yesu will say about me. There is no village you go to, you won't see one project from River State government built under my regime. No one village, I dare. If it's not a health center, we built over 140 to 150 health centers. Let Nyesom Wike tell me what has happened to those health centers. We employed 150 doctors to go to those health centers and man them. There were quarters for those doctors and nurses to live in those health centers. There were generators for those health centers. We built a total of 360 megawatts in 8 years. He's asking that we should account for the money. And he will lie that we got 2 trillion naira, we got 3 trillion naira. We got less than 1.3 trillion naira. And we use it in such a way that people can see what we use the money to do.
May
will be 1 year for him. I hope he knows his clock is ticking. So he should know that it is not how many people he abused. It is not how many lies he tells the public. It is what he's able to deliver. Yes, Wike told me as governor, I should stop project. I should share the money too. That is not, when we go for election, it is not about projects alone. It is how many people we have been able to share money to. Governor.
Your Excellency, you say we find this a little bit difficult, particularly recently. The monorail project is a very big project, a multi-billion naira project. I know you saw that project when you came in, and Governor Wike has said River State government is not interested in that project. Do you consider that?
That's his business. No, I say that's his business. The project was almost completed. The only thing that happened was we became a bit more ambitious. We said, listen, we'll put more than 5 coaches on this rail, and we'll expand it to Yuyibu. So let's expand the biggest terminal. So if you go there now, you see that the terminal we had, if we had ended with this terminal here, by now the train would be running. But because we are doing nothing remaining, just the last terminal where you will wash, maintain the trains and all that at the end of the day, that's all that's remaining. And so we can say, we've told him, let him and Justice Omeleji bring evidence. If you want to fight corruption, take me to court. We have said, in fact, Balaya said, we are waiting for them. He has the River State High Court in his pocket. I said yesterday, have you seen where a judge of the Federal High Court will issue an injunction against National Assembly or River State or State Security Services or Army not to do their duty? That order is illegal and will be disobeyed. When you give such an order, it is illegal and will be disobeyed because you can't stop. It's like saying the River State government shouldn't work. That order that the River State government shouldn't work is illegal and will be disobeyed because the government must do their work. It is when those people carry out their responsibility and it's not carried out in a manner conforming with the law that you can then go to court and the court will say, oh, this is wrong. But they have not even done the duty. You say, stop. Don't do your work.
You know, Your Excellency, Governor Isawan Yesuike was in the studio, this studio last Saturday, and he
if
said,
you told me, I won't have sat here. I'll probably have been standing.
And he said, you are influencing the military agencies in River State. For example, he gave a vivid example of a former DSS director, whom he said is your friend, Tosi Ajayi. And he said, you have lobbied for Tosin Ajayi to be returned here in River State. And also, you are lobbying for other heads of the security agencies just to do the bidding of your party.
Right. Were you here last election?
Yes, I was.
By this time, last election, all APC members, party officers were in detention.
Is this the reason why we have PDP members now in detention?
Is anyone in detention?
Well,
please, name one that's in detention. Name one. He is not enjoying Buhari's rule of law. There is none in detention. Let him name one. By this time last year, APC members, last year, during the election, APC members were on the run. Yesterday, Wike was not yet the governor. He was having Security Council meeting. Brigade commander, police commissioner, Navy commander, Air Force commander, SSS. Election of Yesterday was planned with them. Instead of me, governor, planning election with my security, it was planned with Yesterday, Wike and Mrs. Goodall Jonathan sitting in the meeting. But you know, I always tell people, nobody remembers God. Yes, because they didn't know that there'll be one day that good luck won't win. You realize that? And I told the people, yes, we can do nothing as governor. He is here to steal money. He was my chief of staff. The reason why I removed my chief of staff was stealing. It was Chuma that influenced me to send his name to President Goodluck Jonathan to make him a minister. It was Chuma, my commissioner for commerce. And yes, Uke was dying of taking alcohol. He was so, listen, he's taking so much whiskey that we need to save him. I said, how do we save him? He said, please submit his name to be made a minister. In fact, the first thing Chuma asked me to do was to make him a secretary to government. I said, God forbid. But I removed him because of that corruption. That's the reason why I removed him. But under Chuma's influence, I posted him. And the president, I'll say this next time I'm going for a national interview. The president called me and gave me a report by SSS and EFCC that Nyesom Wike was indicted for corruption. I pleaded with the president to make Nyesom Wike a minister. The same man. We will see how much hole he will leave in the pocket.
You've not really answered the question of you having affinity with Tosin Ajayi and bringing him to.
I've answered. Let's assume that Tosin is my friend. Let's even assume, for purpose of argument, what can Tosin do? Will Tosin go and vote? Will Tosin be the person that will ask? Okay, they have 1,010,000 SSS men in Nigeria. Will all of them come here and vote for this? There will be a free and fair election. The only reason Wike is complaining is that security men won't allow those shooting they did in the last time. They were killing over 100 persons. He's not ashamed that he's seen over the country as a murderer. He's not ashamed. Now, by this time, my first year, people were seeing me as a governor who was producing results. In your first year in office, people are seeing you as a murderer. You have a controversy. I had a Supreme Court judgment, the whole Nigeria was jubilating. You have a Supreme Court judgment, Nigeria has put Nigeria in confusion. I heard Dinkalo in an interview in China said it was the worst decision by the by the by the by the Supreme Court. And I was irresponsible. Imagine a lawyer calling the Supreme Court judge justice irresponsible. But in my time, both the opposition party and those who opposed me and those who supported me jubilated over the judgment. In his own time, there's controversy of what role Mrs. Odili played, but he said it himself.
But do you know if Mrs. Odili actually played any role? Because there have been
something like that.
But he was here in the studio, and I put that question to him, and he denied that actually he was acknowledging everyone who assisted and who stood by him during the election, and he never singled out Justice Odili.
No, but this is what you see. We have it on record now. Is it one thing about even as I'm speaking to you? I know it's on record. We have it on record. If he says it's a lie, we play it for the public to hear. He said that Dr. Odili, who is here, our governor, former governor, our leader, the husband of Justice Mrs. Mary Odili, will call him 12 midnight and say, go here, I went. That's why we're here now. What else is that? What I'm helping is to complete the status for him. because the judge is a judge. So go here must be something. That's why I said clearly yesterday that Nyesom Wike was at the burial of Mrs. Odili's mother. There are two justices in the panel that I'm not calling their names. They were also there at the burial. And they met. So he lives in that controversy. And he could wing the river sepal on controversy until he leaves office.
Your Excellency, we will allow people to call because I know several people are itching to go. But just one question I would ask before I take some calls and we'll come back. When you were talking, you talked about Justice Omerji-led panel of inquiry. Mm. And when you appeared on the floor of the National Assembly while you were being screened as a minister, you produced a copy.
Yes, and I wasn't indicted.
And you said nowhere were you indicted.
In that report.
I have another report. I indicted you. So
bring the report.
Well, that's what has been published by the River State government.
What they published is the white paper, their own, what they accepted. What I brought is not the white paper. There was a variance between the white paper and the report.
But the government is insisting. Even government has a statement, which it used to yesterday, and I have a copy of it. And this is white paper on the report of the Judicial Commission.
White paper is what they say they want. I said there's a variance between the white paper, which was written by Nyesom Wike and his lawyers, and the report itself.
And even this white paper, which I also wanted to, there are allegations that you sold several state assets. There's this, the circumstances of the Omok 150 mega gas turbine, AFM 360 mega gas turbine, many of them here, sale of Olympia Hotel, so many of them. Could you clarify this? Did you sell River State assets?
I did. I don't know whether you've been in university for long. Yeah. When I was building things, the question that was being asked is, how would you maintain these things that you are building? How would you sustain these things that you are building? We built 360 megawatts of power. And the question was, how do you sustain them? We built 28 stations, distribution stations. The question was, how would you sustain them? Right? And I said, don't forget, we are doing town hall meetings. In every town hall meeting I went to, I said, we shall privatize. We either privatize or we commercialize. Why is he not talking about the super board? Because the same thing we did in the power station is what we did in the super board. And when see what he did? He broke it down to Omoku power station. They're all the same power station. So what we did was the same amount of money we bought them is the same amount of money they were sold for. And we sold 70% and retained 30%. So we bought them at $1 million. Odile bought them at $1 million per megawatt. Imagine Dr. Odile's tenure. And these people accepted to pay $1 million at the time we sold it. It was because we had to force a son of the soil. He didn't want to invest. Okay, take Olympia. Olympia has been like that for how many years? Don't forget, Olympia has been like that for more than 40 years. Nobody was moving in, nobody was using it. I brought it forward. I said, okay, now we'll give it to you. Not we didn't sell Olympia because actually Olympia is a lease. They didn't pay us how much, less than 200 million. It was a lease. So bring this place down, build a hotel. After 20 or 40 years, it returns to us as our own. But Olympia can continue to be the way it was. What Nyesom Wike has done is to stop it. Imagine if they had completed Olympia. How many workers? We are trying to create job. See the super board. Do you know how many people are employing? Over 1,000. People go there to watch movies. If at all, Nyesom Wike's criminals will allow them to go to watch movie and go home. By now, by the time I was leaving, over 3 malls would have been established in Port Harcourt. They have withdrawn for fear of insecurity. As Minister for Transportation, they kidnapped yesterday a vessel on the high sea. Tell me which vessel will pass here. As Minister for Transportation, my plan was to rebuild our harbor, our seaports, get business here. Lagos is business. They have no oil. It is trade. So forget oil. Because the oil is finishing. Get this place into a maritime zone so that even if the oil finishes, there will be other business activities to employ people. But we can't do that because nobody wants to come and do that because of Nyesom Wike's inability to protect anybody. As a governor, I protected River State. While people were sleeping, I was awake. I was not sleeping. Every day you met me in the office, my eyes were red because I won't sleep until 5. And when I sleep at 5, by 7, 7.30, I will be in my office. But Nyesom Wike, instead of doing that, is helping to kill people. Helping those who kill people, releasing them on bail.
But you see, many of these are just mere allegations. There are no confirmation on all of this yet because, of course, you have accused police of not doing its job. You said police in River State are looking the other way, and that's even another concern for us. Why would you say
so? Are you satisfied that over 50 persons have been killed and the police cannot arrest one person? This one of Buguma that they say they arrested was not arrested by them. The APC people handed over the person, one of the persons that couldn't run away. As it was when they grabbed the person and handed over to the police. When I was here, it's not the same police. I didn't protect PDP or APC or those who are against Amaechi. My job was every Nigerian living or non-Nigerian living in River State must be protected. Why has Wike not been able to protect anybody? Why is he more interested in, all my enemies must die? Now we are back to protecting people. We will not give Nyesom Wike the right to kill people anymore. On that election day 19th, let his boys come out with guns. Let those his boys that he's training that he say, he comes out, independent lecturers will die. That is an irresponsible governor. Nobody will die on that day. We're here. That's why I came home. So you will say, you're in Abuja, in the comfort of your house. I will be at the forefront of that battle if he comes with his boys.
Your Excellency, we will talk more, particularly I would like to pick your view on the issue that happened in Ogoni. Now, the governor, through statements, has described the issue as not political, but...
I hear about that today. Somebody has just been killed in Ogoni.
Well, we got that news.
You got that.
But of course,
and you have a governor. You don't forget that the oath of office a governor takes, he swears to an oath of office that he will protect lives and properties. The day you can't protect lives and properties, resign. Don't wait to be removed. Nyesom Wike is not able to protect any life or any property. There is not that. If you check the constitution, there's no constitution that says governors must build houses, governors must do road, governors must do water. No, it's not there. What is there in the constitution that as soon as you become a governor, you must protect lives and property? That is impeachable offense. That is impeachable. Not go to carry Justice Somereji and give him some decent and get him to go and do things he don't want to do.
But what you thinking about what happened in Ogoni?
Nothing happened. There is somebody called Solomon in the Bara or whatever his name is who has been killing people. The army went after him. Since the police couldn't, the army is prepared to go back home and wait for war. Because don't forget, Nigerian army has a responsibility to protect the citizens of the country. When police fails to do that, anywhere you see army, then the police has failed. So Musa Kimo has failed completely. Just like Bature failed. Just like what's the man who was there failed. They've all failed. So that's the reason why you see the army. The army is overwhelmed by the number of places they have to deploy. So River State should praise the army.
But you see, the responsibility of the police lies with the federal government, and it is the APC government where we have Solomon Arasi as the IG. Are you inadvertently saying that the president is not acting right if the police has failed?
What is the army? Is the army controlled by a non-APC government? Is the army controlled by a non-APC government? That's why I know if you watch my statement, I said the president has assured us that not one person will die on that day of election. So that he, as the president, will protect every reverse man. Yesterday when I was being interviewed, I said, let us ask ourselves the question, who is our brother? In 8 months of President Buhari, we have Minister for Transportation. My friend, that ministry is big. It's not just big, it's big. If you focus on railway alone, we have two contracts on railway. $12 billion and $8 billion. $20 billion at 200 million at 200 naira per dollar is 4 trillion naira, the biggest contract ever awarded in Nigeria. That is Ministry of Transportation. Maritime alone is enough to have his own ministry, right? Then aviation, and president gave it to a reverse man to manage. What ministry do you get from President Goodluck Jonathan? Ministry of Housing, when you know that housing is for the states. Leave that. The next thing we got from President Jonathan was Minister of State for Education. Today, President Buhari has given us Nimasa. Right? Nimasa doesn't even deal in naira. That's like Maritime does not deal in naira, they deal in dollars. Nimasa is one of the biggest agencies in my ministry to protect the water. They are called coastal guards to protect the waterways. Now that you have Peter said, you will see what will happen to our waterways. We'll clean it up. We'll chase those years the wicked boys out of water. He can keep them on land. He gave us Nimasa. He gave us acting MD of NDDC. In 8 months, in 6 years of our airport is abandoned. And we have agreed, the president has told me clearly, as soon as the budget is passed, go and complete the airport. Go and complete the airport as soon as the budget is passed. As soon as the budget is, in fact, if they check, most people are not even seeing. There's a terminal that we have completed already. The question is, do we open it now or do we leave it? Listen, there's an international terminal. It's completed in Port Harcourt Airport.
Your Excellency, we will talk more about the airport, and we just need to take some calls now. So many people are trying to call in onto the show. 0814761263. 0814-746-1263-0909-6264-639. And for female callers, 0909-542-8778. And we'll just take a couple of calls and we'll come back to the studio. Hello, good morning. Hello.
Yeah, good morning.
Thank you so much for joining us. What's your name and where you calling from? Good morning.
Hello.
Good morning. We can hear you clearly. What's your name?
Hello, good morning.
Yes, we can hear you. Good morning. All right, we have an issue with our line. We'll just take another one. Yes, good morning.
Hello.
Hello, good morning.
Hello.
Hello, good morning. Just turn on the volume on your radio set to avoid the other. Good morning. Thank you for joining us.
Yeah, this is Comrade Samuno.
Comrade, good morning. Your question, please.
Morning, yeah.
Comrade, you have 60 seconds to ask your question. Now, quickly to all our callers, you have 60 seconds to ask your question. All you just need to do, turn down the volume on your radio set to avoid the whole bag. Good morning.
Good morning, Shego.
Yes, what's your name and where are you calling from?
This is Janelle calling from Port Harcourt.
Janelle, 60 seconds, ask your question.
Okay, the question I want to ask our past governor is this. What is his plan to make sure that the killing in River State is of not apportioning blame to Nyesom Wike?
All right.
What you want in River State is peace.
Okay, very well. What is your plan, sir, to assist Rivers people to end the spread of killing? I will just take one more question, Your Excellency, so that you can answer all questions in one swoop. We'll just take this one. Okay. Hello, good morning. Hello.
Good morning, sir.
Thank you so much for joining us. And this is Viewpoint.
Yeah, my name is Boma Alasia. I'm calling from Suku.
Boma?
Yes, sir. Yeah, I want to thank... I'm calling from Suku in Akubuto, Northern Domain.
Yes, Boma, go ahead. You have 60 seconds.
Yes, sir. I want to thank the immediate past governor of River State, His Excellency, the Right Honourable Chief Justice Amaechi. Good morning, sir.
Good morning. How are you, Boma?
Yeah, sir, I want to thank you and again all your attention. I know you are in the cabinet of His Excellency Muhammad Buhari, the President of Nigeria. The insecurity situation in our area, the Oceania area, the area we call Oceania in Agbutoro local government area. A lot of things happened in the previous election, and we are not ready to tolerate that again this time.
Okay.
We'll march to the field and we will vote. But we want you to talk to His Excellency the President so that you send the military there. It is not a question of militarizing the area, but for purposes of security.
Okay.
Boma,
thank you so much. It's the issue of security, Your Excellency. Two issues there. The first caller said, what are you willing to do to assist Rivers people?
If you listen to me very well, I was speaking between the lines. People still want me back as governor.
But you've done it, yes.
Yes, I don't want to come back. I'm saying that they should stop calling me. The security matters in River State concerns the governor of River State. He's the person to deal with the issue of insecurity in River State, not me. The fact that I'm saying here that the president will be forced to bring in the security situation in River State into this is because the governor has failed. We have no business. You see, what we have done so far is allow River State to Nyesom Wike. We don't want to repeat what Nyesom Wike did to us under President Goodluck Jonathan. We want to allow him manage it. If he says he wants a million police, we'll give him a million police. If he says, give me 1,000 soldiers, he gets 1,000 soldiers. He has been given all that he needs to secure the place, and nothing has happened. I have therefore said to River State, we will continue to cry to the president that security is within the listen of the purview of the president. So can you send enough security men to come and check out what is happening in River State and chase away these criminals so that people can live peacefully? Under my regime, they ran away. They were scared. Now they are being recruited every day, even up to my village. What's his name? Obua is in Omoko. Ishi is in Ikwere. Eberi Papa is in Buguma. And these are government officials. They should ask them, what is happening to insecurity in these areas? So if you ask me, what am I going to do as I should stop apportioning blame? It is not my responsibility. I am Minister for Transportation, not Governor of River State. My job, the question should have been, what are you going to do as Minister for Transportation that will benefit River State? Before the end of the year, we will start the construction of railway from Calabar to Port Harcourt. It is actually from Lagos to Calabar. But I said, listen, Lagos to Calabar is 6 years. First starts from Calabar to Port Harcourt so that we can employ River State people, Akwa Ibom people, Abia people, and Cross River people. And they will have some work to do. They will have salaries that we pay to them. There will be micro economy growing in these areas. That will start this year. It will start this year. If you ask that question, I will answer you. We are trying to see how we can redevelop our seaports. The only problem we have is Nyesom Wike's insecurity. If he addresses security, I assure River State that before I leave as Minister for Transportation, I will address the issue of building a new port. In fact, what I'm thinking about is building an industrial park near the seaport.
But Your Excellency, again, if you look at that caller, because you are the leader of the APC in this...
There's a difference between APC and government.
Yes, but because...
APC cannot secure River Nigerians. Government can. And by the Constitution, the chief security officer...
Because the People's Democratic Party has continually accused the APC of instigating the violence. For example, the issue in Ogoni, they're accusing the APC of instigating it.
Shegun, I wouldn't like you to even repeat that. Why I wouldn't like you to repeat that is that... I told you about one Solomon Nderebara also. He killed, let me start from my regime. He okay. killed one innocent Nigerian who lives in Canada, who came home peacefully. He killed the man. We went after him, he ran away. Then they granted him amnesty. Then they gave him security to come down to River State. Then he became a tool with which they want to run the election. Then he continued killing. And when the police couldn't do anything, the soldiers moved in to arrest him. When the soldiers got there, he opened fire on them. So you want the soldiers to die and Solomon should be alive? Then the soldiers responded. Whoever was killed in the course of that response must have been with Solomon.
But Your Excellency, when we interviewed Solomon himself, he accused Senator Magnus.
You saw Solomon?
No, we interviewed him on phone and the interview is available online.
Because they should try and arrest you because you know where he is.
The interview is available.
Police is not looking for Solomon.
The interview is available online and he claimed.
How did you meet
Solomon? He claimed that APC leaders had approached him to work for them in the election and his refusal.
Let's assume it's true. So he agrees he's a criminal. He agrees he kills. So APC in this, I want him to come and help them kill PDP. Look, let him come out. If anybody's after him, for me, I'm after him because of that Canadian Nigerian he killed. Innocent, the man was neither my supporter, nor a PDP or APC member or anything. The man just came home and Solomon went and killed him. He will not know peace until after the tenure of this government.
Your Excellency, we'll just take some calls before we come back to the studio. 0814-7461263. Hello, good morning.
Hello.
Thank you for joining
Hello.
Us. Good morning, Viewpoint.
Yes, my name is Jonathan.
Jonathan, you will need to turn down the volume on your radio set to avoid a hallback, and you have 60 seconds to ask your question.
All right, sir. Your Excellency, sir.
Yes, sir.
I have noticed that whenever you make speeches, you cannot make a complete speech without talking about the former president, You cannot make a complete speech start talking about the governor of Rivers State. You know, so it's like my mother used to tell me something, that when a married man always talks about his former girlfriend, it means he still appreciates her.
Honestly.
So I want to know the reason why you always talk about these two figures.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, Jonathan. Your Excellency, we'll take one more call and we'll come back to the studio. All right. Hello, good morning.
Yeah, good morning, sir.
Thank you so much for joining us. Where's, what's your name and where you calling from?
This is Chibundo Adefula.
Chibundo.
From Rumebo.
You have 60 seconds, please.
Please, it's not a question for my excellency. I just want to thank him for the hospital for this year. I have really just benefited from it. My younger brother has received. He went there and he was using a drug, ED drug, free of charge. You know, so I want to thank the former governor for his good work, to remember that good health is very paramount for the people of River State. His excellency, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Chibudal, thank you so much. We'll just take another one here. Hello, good morning. Hello. Hello, good morning. 0814746123 and 0909626463. Good morning. Thank you for joining us.
Yeah. Please, I'm not asking a question. I just want to see that what the former governor is doing is not coming on air to insult another person. It's not right. He will say he's educated. He should try to be like someone that is educated, not like someone that is an illiterate. Because what he
We were expecting to talk with decorum anyway.
No. Allow people to express their views.
They're expressing
just like I'm expressing my views. You must allow Nigerians. If he wants to insult me or she wants to insult me, let her.
Female callers 0905-0909-542-8778. We'll take this call. We'll take this call now. Hello, good morning. Hello. Hello, good morning. All right, Your Excellency. Yes.
Hello?
Yes, good morning.
Yeah, my name is Captain Tamune James.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah, I want to appreciate His Excellency for coming out open to Rivers people what he has done and what the present government is doing. Rivers people are crying seriously because the present government has failed us. The killing in Rivers City is too much. In the Calabar areas, a lot of us cannot go home, because the militants are back and the present government are supporting them and backing them seriously. So if there is any way His Excellency will assist in the security area, he should assist. Even if we to come to the former style where everybody will be raising hand to work in Port Harcourt, the city of Port Harcourt, we are ready because business are going down and a lot of people are leaving the state.
Okay. Thank you so much. Yes, Your Excellency, the two callers. One, somebody's not happy that you have to mention Governor Wike and President Jonathan every time you make a statement. Like, is it possible you avoid them?
No, don't say that. Why you shouldn't say that is that, first, the issues that were raising are issues that concern the two of them. When Nyesom Wike was abusing me, calling me a thief, I've stolen government money, the young girl didn't hear that. She didn't hear that. One thing I hate, that there are three things I don't want anybody to do to me. Don't call me a thief because I don't like stealing. Don't you ever call me a corrupt man. That's why I say, yes, okay, put the evidence before the public. Don't you ever abuse my wife. Yes, a wicked has abused my wife. Don't you ever abuse my mother. I'm very careful not to do that against anybody else. But these are, I cherish my wife and I love my wife. I love my mother to bits. If you tell my mother, she won't even believe that. But I love my mother to bits. And they are vulnerable people. And I have a responsibility to protect them. Now, he's done all that. And the young guy didn't see Nyesom Wike doing that. Why didn't the young guy also call Nyesom Wike to stop? And that young girl, first is, if he insults me, in our tradition, I'm older than him, I was his boss. What I did when Dr. Dele became left office as governor, there's nothing Dr. Dele did to me, including trying to remove me after I became governor. I never came anywhere any day. In fact, the only day I have come before the public to talk about Dr. Dele is yesterday. And I had taken it to my limit. Don't forget that Dr. Lee had abused me 3-4 times as governor. I never replied. And I made sure that everybody that was working with me never responded to Dr. Lee. Because I was his beneficiary. I benefited from all the things he's done in my life. As my benefactor, I tried to keep away from abusing him. Because if he wasn't there, God used him as a tool to make me governor. I say that to him. I say that to the public. So I owe him that respect. Now, if I kept away from Dr. Lee and everything that concerns Dr. Lee, Nyesom Wike didn't do that to me. Then let's go to the president. I met somebody who told me, see, Governor Amaechi, your election was planned, executed here in the villa. Yes, we get election. We remember that Mike Iginni was posted to River State. We removed him and brought Mrs. Khan. We gave Mrs. Khan specific directives. We removed all the resources in River State and gave to Nyesom Wike. But here, it's not happening soon. Tomorrow, if you don't see the resource sheet, you cry out. And the resource sheet must come. INEC has promised there will be free and fair election. I mean, on the 19th. So if President Goodluck Jonathan did all that he did in the course of bringing us to where we are now, I don't come. Okay, the person is saying, must you always talk about Jonathan? When I went to inspect the railway, I talked good about Jonathan. Why didn't she tell me, why are you talking good about Jonathan? I said, this railway was commenced under the government of President Goodluck Jonathan, even though we are finishing it. I could have done what Nyesom Wike is doing. Abandon project, we have finished it. In fact, I will even say we started it. But you know, you can't start a railway in less than 1 year and finish it in 1 year. So tell her that's the reason. The reason is that there will continue to be a recurring decimal in the course of the politics of River State until Nyesom Wike goes away.
Your Excellency,
there was a second question.
Yes.
That was, I forgot the question that somebody asked before the lady spoke.
Actually, the person was talking about you commenting and also what you can do to assist.
Oceania.
Yes.
Well, like you said, it's not enough to protect them on the election day. On the election day, tell him for free there will be protection. What I can assure him is that with Dr. Adol Peter Sai becoming the DG of Nimasa, all that creeks and river fall under him. And Niwa, who police other river, who police up to Kola and Soku, so take him for free. We don't need the permission of Nyesom Wike to protect, to police that place, and we will not use police. We will use both the navy and the army to protect that place. So this will be out of business very soon. We will not come to brigade commander or navy commander, anybody. We will go from the federal, ask chief of naval staff, give us people to police our waterways from Kola to Borne until you leave the Borne. We'll do the same to Akwa Ibom. We'll do the same to Cross River. I'm speaking now as Minister for Transportation. Don't forget that Nimasa is under me.
Yeah.
Because our waterways must be clean to allow business flow if we must attract investment. Yes, so we can battle with people on the mainland, but water is our business. So I want to reassure our brothers and sisters in the Oceania area that we will protect them on the day of election. They should allow us go back to Abuja to plan with the new DG of Nimasa on how to protect our waterways.
Your Excellency, let's talk politics a little bit now. The March 19th election is a big election. 3 senatorial seats, 12 out of the 13 House of Representatives seats, the State House of Assembly, big one, and so much can still happen. But it seems as if after you left River State, your party, the APC, went into comatose. So do they need you to re-engineer them?
Why are you lying? You know, I told you when I came here, that you were accused of being a PDP member and that this station is a propaganda machine for PDP and...
Your Excellency, we're journalists.
And journalists on one side alone.
We're journalists.
Journalists on the side of PDP.
We're present both sides.
This is the first time that APC is having it in your studio. the progressive radio stations didn't want me
I'm
to come
sure
here.
I'm very sure that the APC will speak whether that's true, sir. But Your Excellency,
APC that told me, APC and the radio stations that were on the side of
APC. But Your Excellency, the question is, if APC is strong in university, why would they need you to come and re-engineer them?
Am I not a member of APC? No, tell me why. Just like Nyesom Wike led the campaign yesterday to Ahuda East. Because he's the leader of PDP in River State. I'm the leader of APC in River State, and I have to lead my troops.
So you have a national assignment.
Yes, we can have a national assignment. In fact, in his own case, he abandoned his office completely. I'm not abandoning my office. I'm not. I'm coming here for a week. I'll be here till election day. Let us see that Nyesom Wike and his shooting, man to man. He's the governor, he has his troops. I am minister, I have no troops, but we'll face each other here and see that this insecurity, all this unnecessary harassment, you would die. As governor, have I ever threatened anybody that you would die? I've never. In fact, I see the things that never happened when I was a governor. I see people parking on the road, I see unnecessary traffic. When I was governor, you dare not drive against traffic. You dare not. We'll arrest you and ask them to prosecute you. But under this current government, things have gone back to what it was before I became governor. And really, you know, when somebody told me that, please ensure you have a successor. If not, all these things you did in 8 years will go to naught. I say, after 8 years, no matter who you bring, it will not. Now, it's almost going to naught. Because Nyesom Wike has abandoned the schools. They now pay school fees. I introduced free education because I come from a poor background. I know that poor people can't pay school fees. So I introduced free education. Nyesom Wike is charging school fees. I introduced free health care, including the dental center I built. The first in West Africa to have a dental center on its own, standing on its own. I got in doctors from America. Don't forget, go to Caribbean White. You have South African doctors, you have Indian doctors, you have Pakistanis, you have American doctors. There. And it was free. Now, Chibuike is not a governor. He has come to collect money. I've said it very liberally that the only reason why he's here is to collect more money. But he will account for it too. when they open Ministry of Education, you know this corruption thing they're investigating. They are there in Ministry of Education, Federal Ministry of Education. If you see, when my colleagues give me the documents, and you see this money stolen by Yesu Wiki, you'll be shocked.
Your Excellency, we would just say, just before I take calls and so many
I think you should deal with issues of development in my regime.
No,
vis-a-vis development in the
regime. That's what we're looking at, because you see, you talked about the issue of schools.
There was power when I was governor. We were supplying power from our power stations.
But the power problem is a national problem.
No. We did not wait for the national. The power consumed by Rivers people when I was governor was supplied from our power stations. We had. I built the first set. This I built was 180 megawatts. It's there in Ogoni. I said it's construction of a second 180 megawatts. That's why I say 360. I completed that so-called Omoku. I will say it before. I used to say all the built Omoku. I completed. There were two machines that were done. There were 50 megawatts. I completed it. I did. Two machines were done in Port Harcourt. They were not completed under the regime of Doto Dele. I completed it, but then I used to say, oh no, all the built all the megawatts in Omo and Port Harcourt. That was what I was saying, because it was my boss. I don't have to go after your boss. But now I want to say to you, you can ask Arik. I completed it. I brought the money for the machines to be brought down, to be completed and put on the national listing. I built 28. That I was a power upsurge was because I built 28 new substations to take power to people's houses. Yes, so Wike should tell me one thing he has done. Not to whitewash roads. Let me tell you one thing we did. The first thing we did when we got into government is to call experts. Please teach us. We are not experts. Teach us. And the first thing they told us about roads, if you don't do a proper drainage, roads will wash off. Now, you have potholes. So he prepares the potholes and then overlays it. It will go bad because the drainage that caused that pothole is still not there. Right? We asked them what's the solution. They say we must take away water to the waterways. So we began to build underground drainage. Check our roads. Even this one, check. And we said all the drainage must lead out to a creek.
But Your Excellency, we have Julius Berger doing our roads.
Which one is that?
Julius Berger.
What makes Julius Berger the best? We chase them out of this place. Okay, the Julius Berger should tell us what road they have done. They should tell us what road they have done. One road. Name one road Julius Berger has done. The Transamadi Road, I awarded it and gave it to RCC with three flyovers, six bridges. Yes, we ask them for bribe. You know, these are contractors that know me. This is your guy, you are a different Nigerian.
Okay, Your Excellency, let's just come to the social media. We have several questions coming here. One says, Your Excellency, what efforts have you made as a reverse man to restore peace and development in the West? And what do you plan to do in reviving seaports in Niger Delta?
That's the question I should answer. Says,
over as the new Minister of Transportation. We saw your commission and also amount new rail coaches. Were they constructed as you assume? I think you've talked about that. Please tell Nigeria. So, seaports in the Niger Delta.
Let's start with the last question. I told Nigerians, President Goodluck Jonathan has tried. He started this railway and we are going to finish it. We are almost finishing it. It's difficult to finish because the contractor said for 2 years he has not been paid, and we said the economy was bad, so we paid him. We've never claimed to have started everything, so the young man should not ask that question. The second question, what are we going to do? I've told you that we are prepared to bring a new seaport into River State. The problem we have is that people are afraid to come and even take the contract. That's to even take the contract. Not, you know, when you have, and this is a quarter of $2 billion, $3 billion, so it should excite people to come and take, but they're afraid. Why? Because every day you wake up, it's the weakest talks have killed somebody. and these things are not hidden. They are there in the international media, people coming from America and other. So nobody's willing to come in. If not, I don't want to leave office knowing that our seaports are not working. But the seaport here is not working. The seaport here is not working. In fact, I was asking MPA to go and fix the road between the seaport and the government house, which they would do. I've told you here that by the time we leave, not by this year, we'll commence work and complete work at the Port Harcourt International Airport. Before we even commence work there, we would have moved everybody to the new terminal. We have completed the new terminal at the airport, which we have not opened. We'll open it and get the president to commission it before May 29th. And then we'll move people there and then complete this one and supervise it very well. When they finish, we transfer domestic passengers to the old domestic wing and then use the other one for international passengers. So if it's what I'm doing, I will just wait. Not me. It's President Buhari will change the face of South. Don't forget, I've just said here that he's approved that they should commence the construction of the Port Harcourt, I mean Lagos Calabar railway. It will start from Calabar to Uyo, to Aba, to Port Harcourt, to Tuoki, to Yunagua, to Ueli, to Wari, to Sapele, to Benin, to Abo, to Asaba, and Onitsha. So we have finished the whole of the South cities. There's none left. And that is not a man from the South. He's a man from the North. So who is your brother, Shegun?
Your Excellency, we'll take some calls.
Who is your brother?
Your Excellency, we'll take some calls. 0814-7461-263, 0909-6264-639. Hello, good morning.
Hello, good morning.
Thank you so much for joining us. Welcome to Viewpoint.
Good morning, the Honorable Minister. My name is Kennedy Friday. Good morning, Shegun.
Yes,
thank you. Morning, how are you?
Well, Honorable Minister, I quite appreciate all you have said this morning. And I am a resident, I'm an indigenous of River State. I'm resident here. And I'm seeing everything that is happening. This state is under fire. This state is under fire. Just today in the community, somebody has been put from his house and shot dead in Yege community, where these people come from. What is happening in River State? Everywhere is under fire. Gunmen are terrorizing everybody. You cannot be sure of what to say or what to do, and we live in perpetual fear. What do we do, Your Excellency, to bring this situation under control?
All right. Thank you so much, Kennedy Friday. We'll take another call. And hello, good morning. Hello. 0814-7461-263, and for female callers only, 0909-542-8778. Hello, good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you so much for joining us. Please, you may need to speak a little bit louder. Hello.
Hello, good morning, Chairman.
Thank you.
My name is Wanosuke Samuel.
You need to speak a little bit louder. It's difficult for us to.
My name is Wanosuke Samuel. I am the chairman of the Kure Local Government Council.
Okay, very well. Good morning.
Yes, my question is straight to the Honorable Minister for Transportation. That is he aware that all the kidnap activity and the kidnap ransom that have been happening in River State and money being paid have been recovered from his community, his family in Ubima?
Do you
and
have that
the 9th that? Of November, when I became council chairman, the security report has it that 19 kidnap camps exist in Ubima. We have men and women of River State and Nigerians are being kidnapped and robbed and killed on a daily basis in his community. And these actions have been happening even when he was governor. What has he done, 8 years as speaker, 8 years as governor, in stopping that thing, that insecurity issue, that killing of innocent people in Ubima community?
All right. Now, thank
that
you so much.
You have 60 seconds.
No, you have 60 seconds. Now, I'm very sorry. I'm very sorry, but we told everybody that 60 seconds, you have a 60 seconds to ask your question. Hello, good morning.
Hello.
Is that the only first one? I thought that was the second one.
We have another caller. Hello, good morning. Yeah, what's your name, please? Hello, what's your name? Well, we have a very bad telephone line, but we're going to give advantage to the female callers, and we just allow one more female call to come in. Hello, good morning. Hello. All right. Now, Your Excellency, maybe you may want to answer those two questions before we take
now. Let's start with Anosike. He's a young man that, when I became governor, we brought into government house. We gave him contract. He used the money after that contract to buy a car, and I said, this small money you got from this contract, you bought a car. The first thing you do is to see how you can reinvest the money so it can be somebody in the future. He said no, he wants to go and tell all his enemies that he has arrived. He hired a driver.
But Your Excellency is talking about ease of killing.
I'm coming.
Are you aware of it first?
I'm coming. Let me answer my questions now. Don't put all this in my mind. So that's the character of the person. Again, he was arrested by SSS for killing when he was a student in the University of Science and Technology. He was arrested. Not when I was governor, when I was speaker. His family ran to me. I asked SSS, do you have evidence? If you have evidence, take him to court. If not, 48 hours will be too much to hold him. They released him. Now, he said, my community. Correct. Who are those who are being killed in my community? APC members. I had to request the Nigerian army to please go and protect my community. Because they began to cry out that, oh, it's because of me, Nyesom Wike is killing them. Because of me, Nyesom Wike is killing them. I had to call the army. Please, Chief of Army Staff, we need people to protect my community. As I'm talking now, the only way we can secure my community is because you have soldiers in that community. And the boys were led by the same man Osike from Omagwa. Okay. He says, all my family members are in Abuja. So my family cannot be kidnapping. My family members are with my mother in Abuja, and therefore can be kidnapping. So the Anosike man, who is Tango, he says, chairman of council, he belongs to the secret court.
But Your Excellency, you don't have a clear fact to that.
No, I do. He was my boy. I said he was arrested by SSS. He has a file in SSS. They're all afraid. You know, if this government goes, they're all afraid that people will run out of this country if the government goes. If after 4 years, that this government is no longer in place, after 4 years, these are people that won't stay now, because he has a record with the police, he has a record with SSS. He's been protected by the governor of Rivers State. The next question is again the issue of security. But I've discussed the issue of security. I'm not the governor of Rivers State. I can only do the best I can. Like I promised now that the waterways will be cleared because the matter is under me. That I can do. I hope the commissioner of police will know what to do and stop going to the governor to collect money.
Your Excellency, again, you're not certain that the commissioner of police is collecting money from
the
governor.
He told me.
He told you so?
Yes.
Your Excellency, let us just leave that. Maybe I need to take more calls, and we have another call coming through here. Hello, good morning. Hello, good morning.
Hello, good morning.
Thank you for joining us. Tell us the name and where you're calling from.
You know what I said? When I said he told me. Okay. When I said he told me. He told me that they can't run their, what's it called? They can't run the police command without the governor giving them money. So when I said money, it's not as bribe. It's money he says he collects from governor to run his command. So if he collects money from governor to run his command, please tell me where his loyalty will be.
Is it not the responsibility of the governor to fund the police? Is it not part of the responsibility of the
governor? I don't know. But one thing everybody will tell you when I was governor of Rivers State was that while I was funding police, I never used the police. While I was funding the police, I never used the police. Any day I woke up and I saw, there's a crime in Omoko or there's a crime in Ubima. Commissioner of Police, are you aware of this crime? I never asked whether it was a PDP or APC or anybody. Go after the criminals.
But Your Excellency, for the Commissioner of Police to have come to tell you that they receive money from government to run their affairs, isn't this a failure of the APC-led federal government?
A lot of the person wants to ask questions to ask this question.
Okay, Your Excellency, we'll take more calls, and many comments are coming in on our Facebook and Twitter handle. We'll just try to read as many of them as possible. Hello, good morning. Hello. Now, you need to turn down the volume on your radio set, please. If you must call us to participate on the show, kindly turn down the volume on your radio set. Hello, good morning. Hello.
Hello, good morning.
Thank you for joining us. This morning. Is Report. Good morning.
My name is Honorable Goodluck, please switch in now.
Honorable Goodluck, good morning.
Yeah, I'm calling for the local government through Mujita.
Very well.
Yeah, morning. I want to ask is the former governor of Rivers State, what happened to Port Harcourt Airport Hotel during his regime before he left as the governor of state? Because that place like a bush. Reptiles are living in that place. Something is happening there. Whenever you pass that place looks like a forest. What happened? Can he just explain to Rivers people what really happened at that place? It's abandoned.
Okay, thank you so much. And hello, good morning.
Good morning.
Yes, thank you so much. What's your name and where are you calling from?
My name is Mr. Charles.
I can hear that. Please, what's your name?
Ch-
Charles, good morning, Charles.
Your Excellency, good morning. It's unfortunate. I want to take you on the issue of power.
Yes.
You said you sold the power plant to Tonya Coal.
No, to Sahara, when you were governor, to Sahara Energy.
To Sahara Energy.
Yes.
And when you were governor, you said the power plant was controlled by River State government and you were giving people River State light. But when you now you have sold the power plant to you, Tonya Coal, your friend Sahara reporters, and we no longer have light. Are we supposed to blame the River State government for that inability to give us power, or your friend that you sold the power to?
Okay, that's the question. Okay,
let me answer that before I forget that. Again, what Nyesom Wike has done as the governor of River State is to stop the people who bought the plant from utilizing the plant. So they can't go there to maintain the plants. So the plants are breaking down. They can't go there to change spare parts. They can't use the plants because he's policing the place and not allowing them to operate. So who do you blame? The gentleman who bought the plants with billions of naira, or Nyesom Wike, the governor, who has refused to allow them to go? So if power is down, hold your governor. I'm no longer governor of River State. The other man asked about International Airport Hotel. International Airport Hotel was part of our development of the new city. So we refuse to allow anybody to go in there until we have finished developing the new city. There are people who are ready to come and buy the International Airport Hotel and run it as soon as we're able to develop the new city. So tell the gentleman it was part of the Greater Port Harcourt Development Master Plan.
Your Excellency, let's move away from River State. I know you're interested, you want to talk about politics, but let me talk about something else.
No, I want to know that people will know correct the facts. Yes, we can say to me that I was owing salary. He should call any worker that I was owing salary apart from April that I've started paying before I left office.
Okay,
but he was lying. Yes, so we can say to me that we sold the plants and put the money in our pocket. We have evidence, is there in the Zenith Bank. The Nigerians can use, which act is that, Freedom of Information Act, to ask Zenith Bank to give them the account, how, whether the money was paid into our account or not, and the names of the contractors that we paid for the jobs that they did. Now, again, under the man who said we shouldn't mention President Goodluck Jonathan, under President Goodluck Jonathan, Ogoni cleanup was there. Ordinary $1 billion. Jonathan hated River State so much that he couldn't release $1 billion to clean up Ogoni. Under President Buhari, less than six months in President Buhari's regime, $1 billion has been released to Federal Ministry of Environment. I was just speaking with the minister this morning. They want to come and launch the cleanup here and take off for the cleanup. Who is your brother, Shegu? The man who bought $1 billion, or the man who sees the $1 billion?
Let me talk about something that is on your table right now. The federal government is still going ahead with a planned national carrier. I mean, what's the position of the planned national carrier?
We will not put much money. It will be PPP, private investors. So
okay. All
we're doing is, let's have a carrier that has Nigerian flag, so you can be proud of. Just like you have South African Airlines, you have Ethiopian Airlines, you have British Airways. Let's have something called Nigerian Airways or Nigerian something, whatever it is, that carries Nigerian flag. It may not belong to us because we don't want to put that money. It will belong to investors. Just like we're trying to put up a national shipping carrier. That will be by 40% foreign investment, 60% local investment, not Nigerian government investment, but it will carry Nigerian name as either Nigerian national shipping line or Nigerian shipping line or something with a Nigerian flag. We just want to make sure that we clean up our image. Yeah,
Your Excellency, You went to China recently. You were on the delegation of the federal government that was in China.
Yeah.
What was the outcome of that trip? And how is it
going to
help us?
Well, I mentioned that we've gotten $20 billion loan. That's huge, isn't it? If you go to black market, it's 6 trillion naira. If you go to official market, it's 4 trillion naira. To do this railway from Lagos to Calabar and from Lagos to Kano. That's the achievement we had.
Let's talk about two things you've mentioned here.
And they are going to release $3.5 billion this year. Okay. So imagine $3.5 billion in the economy. Out of this $3.5 billion, $2 billion will come to Lagos Calabar, and $1.2 will go to Lagos Kano. So you can imagine. The same President Buhari, who is your brother, Shegu.
Your Excellency, Nimasa and NDDC, they are big cash cows. And
how do you do that?
Well, the People's Democratic Party used them big time, and now you
to do what? To steal money.
Well, Your Excellency,
we will not use them in that manner. We will use them. You know, when I got in there, that's why Nigerians say, I said we will scrap Nimasa. I never said we will scrap Nimasa. I said if Nimasa had given out their responsibility to Global West, a company, I don't know who owns it, and they pay quite a huge amount of money every month. Some allege it's $2 billion naira per month. I wish I had that contract where they pay me 2 billion naira per month. But I don't know what the actual cost. I will find out from the ministry.
Okay.
Well, let's assume they pay 2 billion naira per month. And then they now perform the responsibility of NIMASA. As if they do that, then there's no basis for which you should have NIMASA. What is the implication of that statement? That NIMASA should please take back that responsibility. Yes, but I don't know about being cash cow.
Okay, let's come back and take some telephone calls. 0909-5428-778 and 0909-626-4639 and also 0814-746-1263. Hello, good morning. Hello.
Good morning.
Thank you so much for joining us. Viewpoint. Yes.
Yeah, good morning, Shego.
We can hear you clearly. Good morning.
Yeah, my name is Fela Chris. I'm coming from Boston.
All right. Go ahead, your question.
Yeah, good morning. So I'm calling from Portugal. My name is Mila Cringe.
We can hear you, Mila. Just turn on the volume on the radio.
Your foreign minister, Chibuike Amaechi, when he was the government of Rivers State, what happened that Rivers City could not write Neko? That's number one.
Could not write
Neko? Was it 3 years a week that Rivers people not to write Neko at the same time the back terminal to use? Was it introduced that stopped the back terminal to work? Thank you. That's my question.
All right, Neko, you stop.
I stopped Neko. The standard of Neko was too poor. I said all the people should write to West African Examination Council exams. So that when you have your certificate, you are proud of it. And West African Examination Council exam, if you pass it, you can use it in Ghana, in Sierra Leone, in London. What is Neko? Myself and Cross River State Governor, two of us banned Neko. What is that? You should be proud of me that I'm raising standard.
Okay, we'll just take a...
And tell him we are paying the exam fee for those who are writing West African Examination Council exams.
We have another call, yeah. Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you, sir. Very good. Could you turn on the volume on your radio set? Thank you.
Hello.
We can hear you. You turn on the volume on your radio set. Tell us the name and where you're calling from.
Okay, my name is Promise. From
Promise, good morning. Your question, Promise.
Good morning. How are you?
Fine, thank you. Please, can you clear this issue? In June 2011, when you called us as stakeholders of PDP from Ahoda West, in government house, you told us that you are bringing out 3 billion naira, 1.5 Ahoda East, 1.5 Ahoda West, to enable the party people to fund the campaign of the local government chairmanship election. And after that, you gave the contract to the sitting house of West Member, who became the vice deputy governorship candidate, Honorable Akita, to walk a road from Indiana to Akinuma, which was not done. And when you came for a stakeholders meeting in Akinuma in 2013, a question was asked regarding that contract and the money. At the end, you got angry and you said they should take away the microphone from the person who was asking the question. And the Honorable House of Reps member came out and knelt down in the public to beg you not to be angry for not containing those who are Christian and who did not. Can you explain to Rivers people if that was corruption or if it was not corruption? My name is Tony Jacob. Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much.
What was the first question?
The first question, is on the issue of. Was still talking about security.
No, it was Neko.
Neko,
and I've answered that one. I've answered that. Okay, this one is first. I don't know if you know me very well. I can never be a person that will go to a public function and say I will give people 3 billion naira. So the man, this man, he must be lying. I can never go to a public ceremony. I can never give. You know what is 3 billion to give to local government 3 billion for election? That election, are we electing God? There's no way you can spend 3 billion for two local government elections. It's not possible. But let's leave that because that is a lie. What happened at Akinuma was we drove on that road. The road was constructed, but it ended somewhere. And I asked, why should it end here? I didn't even know that there was a part B of that contract, or phase two of that contract, which we needed to award, and I was not awarded. So my anger, if I thought I was angry, nobody has briefed me that this road did not get to the end. I thought that was the end of Akinuma. John Krama. And they said, no, they have JK1, JK2. I joked in that place. I said, you have up to JK6. That my intention was to construct this road up to JK whatever and clear that place. And I'm happy that he acknowledged that we drove on that road and got to the venue. But at the end of that, before we got to the venue, we discovered that from that point where the road stopped to that, where they were not constructed. And we confirmed that the River State government will go to award the new contract to take the road to the end. If we did that, I can't remember if we did that, because at the point we didn't have money anymore.
Your Excellency, we have some messages coming on our Facebook. Caleb Abinere said, please ask His Excellency that the NPA recruitment done in 2014 and up to now, the list of that NPA aptitude test result is not out. Are you aware of that?
I'm not aware.
Now, I don't want to say, Honorable Minister, he says, Minister for Transportation, Chief and former Governor Amaechi, my question is that since insecurity cannot be unaccounted with lack of employment by the youth, are you willing to assist this government to create employment opportunities?
We are. I just said that the reason why I said instead of constructing from Lagos to Calabar, I'm constructing from Calabar to Lagos, is to create employment in the South. Because we're creating employment by starting from Lagos to Kano. So we're starting this year from Lagos to Ibadan. Now, that will create employment between Ibadan and Lagos. We cannot also start from Lagos to Benin, because that will create employment only for Lagos and may not even get to Benin this year. So I said the best way the South can benefit from it is to start from Calabar to Port Harcourt, so that all those who live around here can benefit. And don't forget, we said about if we finish the Lagos Calabar to Lagos Kano, we'll create about 240,000 employment opportunities. What else are we doing? We are going to reform the seaports. I'm thinking, why is the Port Harcourt seaport not working? They've told me the draft, they told me the berth, they've told me. I'll look at all that to see how we can create employment opportunity again at the seaport. All those people who have taken MPA land and built houses, yeah, we'll go after them. We don't need the permission of the university government to go after them, because they're our land. It's our land. We don't have anybody's permission. We'll just go clear the places and expand. Because the problem people have with the Port Harcourt seaport is that it cannot be expanded anymore, because people have taken on the land that belong to MPA. So you need to chase those people away to be able to expand that place, because a greater percentage of Nigerians or Rivers people will get employment from that seaport if we make it function.
Your Excellency, Maxwell Dokuro, referring to the case of Solomon Idibara, said, let's assume that indeed Solomon Idibara has a case to answer with the police. Does that justify the military presence? Shouldn't the police be allowed to do their job?
The police were not doing their job. Yeah, I hope you listened to me very well. Police were not doing their job. So the army went to arrest Solomon Idibara, or Idibara, whatever they call him. When they went, Solomon and his people opened fire on the army. The army, the soldiers are still human beings. They're not ghosts. They had to respond to protect their lives.
Your Excellency, I don't know, say good morning, Right Honorable Chibuike Rotimi Amaechi. I'm Professor Emmanuel Dema from Ogoni. Please, I want to know why Ogoni Sapoma Road, which was promised from your first to second tenure, was never done.
Because there was no money.
Promises is playing out now in this new regime.
This week should tell me what he has done. He's collected over 50 billion naira as loan. When I was governor, loans were collected and tied to a project. Let him show us. See, yes, what Yes Wike does is give me 50 billion and the banks will give him. In my own case, I don't say give to this project 3 billion, this project 2 billion, like that, until we get. And the total of 300 billion was borrowed to those projects, and all those projects were completed. And we paid back to the point where we left just 17 billion naira as debt. Compared to other states, how many states can proudly say that? Some states left 400 billion, 500 billion, I left just 17. 17 I paid back. And I still paid salaries up till April. But yes, we will come. There's only 12 months. Not. I paid April.
Your Excellency, another one says here now, you said that you would go to the Chief of Naval Staff to get Navy on the waterways. Are you saying our police are incapable?
No, but police don't have that expertise. We will also go with Marine Police. Well, but Navy will be, Navy will be the best. Marine Police and the Nigerian Navy will man the waterways. If we need to get the amphibious part of the Nigerian Army, we will also plead with them. But don't forget, I'm not talking as Minister for Transportation. I'm not saying that I'm going to protect, I'm not interested in protecting River State waterways. I'm protecting protecting the national waterways, and they fall within the purview of my ministry.
Then also Benson Oyubo said, Your Excellency, please tell us the state of education and the health sector in River State when you left it.
Kai, at that time we had produced even about 38 doctors had returned from overseas. Then the rest who graduated from Canada became Canadian citizens. I complained to the Canadian ambassador. We had progressed to the point where we were now if not the second best in terms of West African Examination Council results in the country. And the other people was up because the percentage of people who wrote the exams were very few. We had progressed to a point where our people were becoming experts in computer, because we made sure we made it compulsory for our children to study computer sciences. Now, all those things have been shut down. It's, there's a difference between going to school and learning. So they should ask their governor.
I was worried that Rivers people would suffer this, but unfortunately, other things have been abandoned.
Another one says here, Honorable Minister, sir, could you use your office as Minister for Transportation to conclude the monorail project?
No, it's not possible. It's a state government project, and like I said, it was below 1 billion naira to complete it. It was also complete the last terminal. Once you complete the last terminal, the train was going to run.
And we have another comment coming here. Said the multi-billion naira Rizom Pam project was gutted by fire. How do you feel about
that? What was that? No, it's not a Rizom Pam. It's the banana plantation.
The banana plantation. Yes.
PDP talks. PDP talks.
No, you are not certain that.
We have a police report to that effect.
That it is PDP.
It happened when I was the governor. When I was the governor, first, and we ran after them. We were arrested, and they confessed. They were sent to go and do that. And you see, that is a private investment. I feel sad because they were employing almost every month 500 persons. It's unfortunate. You know, I can't talk about being literate and being illiterate, and being educated and being non-literate.
Okay.
What did the governor do? He should by now have brought those who did that to book. He has not even found that. Okay, take the fish farm. Take the fish farm. I built how many fish farms so far? One in Ubima. I hear they've sold it to their commissioner for agriculture. They sold one in Buguma to the commissioner for agriculture.
To the present commissioner for agriculture.
Yes, but it's not a bad idea. That's a business. I don't know who they sell it to. But is it functioning? The answer is no. And the reason for starting the fish farm was to create employment. So we created one in Ubima, one in Buguma. The one in Andone was almost completed. We are doing one at Opobo. Where again? I think at least four. We have to do six. Let Nyesom Wike tell us one thing he has done. I continue to repeat, and I will repeat it. Let by this time, when my first year in office, I was a commissioning project. By this time, all this okay is in one item agenda. One item. Amaechi is so scared of me. Anytime you see, he just walks with me now. Anytime you see him shouting, Amaechi, he's afraid. You know, this is the first time I'm coming out after I left office. What I said, he's the governor. I give him his opportunity to show his skills. Let him show capacity. When I was campaigning, I named roads that Nyesom Wike took. All the roads around Jarue, Nyesom Wike took them. Tell me how many he was able to complete. The road between Eneka and Ropoku, he has awarded it to himself. It was awarded to him fully paid. The road between Origwe, they were all awarded to Nyesom Wike as a contractor. He bought machines, he would do this and that, and he did nothing.
Thief. But you see, you're
right. They call it thief.
In all of these,
D-I-F-F.
In all of these, there is still an amusing part of it, which has been canvassed by some politicians, that irrespective of what you and Governor Nyesom Wike are putting to the public, is a planned agenda by the Equerries.
Question number two. You know, but the other way to answer this question is, for me, I believe that the Equerries cannot be the sole experts in governance. Other parts of River State should be given that opportunity. That was what the Ikwe people fought for. They fought for it. The Ikwe people won that battle. They too should not monopolize the office of the governor. Other people should be given the opportunity to serve River State. But yes, Ikwe didn't come in as an Ikwe governor. He came in as somebody who was desperate that he could sell his mother, desperate that he could betray me, desperate that he even denied that I nominated his name to be minister.
We'll just take some calls now and we'll come back to the social media, and we have several calls.
Hello.
Good morning. Yes,
this is a 2-hour interview.
Yes, good morning.
Good morning.
Yes, good morning.
Yeah, this is Comrade Tamuno.
Comrade Tamuno, good morning.
Yeah, please, can the governor, the former governor, tell you what people, what happened to pensioners, that they didn't pay them family months, and the pensioners now told him that he will not see all the not paying their allowances and gratuity. He should go back and beg for their forgiveness so that he will see all this. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Tamino. And we have another call coming through here. And don't forget our female callers, 0909-542-877. Hello, good morning. Hello. Hello, good morning. Hello, good morning.
Hello, good morning.
Thank you for joining us.
Thank you. This is Tamuna Yowuna Innocent, Uranta.
Tamuna Yowuna Innocent. Good morning.
Uranta.
Yes.
Thank you. Please, I want to still talk to our Honorable Minister. Honorable Minister, good morning, sir.
Good morning. How are you?
Mister, if there is anything you can do to protect us in this state, please help us. Even we, the APC members at the social media, Facebook, are being threatened. As I said before yesterday, somebody just drove by me on the street and stopped and said, you innocent or rather, you've been posting everything, saying all sorts of rubbish on Facebook. You think you are invisible. We are not ready for you yet.
Innocent is intimidation. That's why I came back. That's why I came back. It's intimidation. They don't ignore them. Let them come. On that day of election, let anybody come out with his gun. I'm daring Nyesom Wike. You know, he has, oh, I will go to INEC. Oh, I will keep police. I will keep police. Oh, I will kill Uniport. We are back. We are here.
But the governor himself is not in support of rigging. He said here that he will resist all form to rig the election.
Tell him to resist. Tell him I say he should resist. One assurance I give Nigerians, INEC has promised us a free and fair election. Unlike the last INEC where Nyesom Wike was writing results. You go to this man's house, Senator Judge Sekibos. Up to the third day, they were still writing results. Soldiers were everywhere because he was chairman of defense in this. Let him write again now. Now he's no longer chairman of defense, so there will be no, if you see any soldier there, that soldier will know. They were writing results and doing all sorts of things. Yes, we could go. He was working as a tiger. You will see a dog on Saturday. On that Saturday, he must allow a free and fair election. We believe that, at the time I left office, I was 75% by poll popular in River State. We believe that we would have won the election if it was free and fair. And yes, Wikide was bragging how popular he was. He should have shown that popularity on the field.
But Your Excellency, again, the question that comes to mind, because I have read on the internet where the APC said it has 1 million registered voters.
That's why I'm here.
Now, if you have that, you need not worry.
Are we worried? Are we complaining? The person who is complaining is Nyesom Wike. We're here to mobilize our base. Let the base come out. What is trying to do? You know that we have that population. What is trying to do is to intimidate that population from coming out. And we're saying, no, come out. Nyesom Wike, we do nothing. And I assure you, Nyesom Wike, we do nothing. Absolute nothing. That day, you will see security in rivers, and you will be worried about the security. The security will police everywhere to ensure that everybody can vote. So we're not afraid of election. As APC complain about election, the complaint is, oh, the governor is basically complaining that something is happening. We are going to mobilize our base to come out to vote. That's why I'm here. I'm going to, from village to village from tomorrow, begging our supporters to come out. We shall protect them. Yes, we can, on the other hand, is killing them so that they don't come out.
Your Excellency, you know, I'm trying to avoid, we come to the
basis. Is you that went there now?
Okay,
I killed it by saying, can we go to development and forget the governor? Because he's having his tenure, we should give him support. I will give him support as the former governor of River State.
Okay. That's what I said. Your Excellency, we have a call. Good morning.
Good morning, Mr. Shishego.
Yes, good morning.
Yes, good morning, our minister.
Good morning, sir. How are you?
Mr. Shishego, let me take our minister out of the security zone now.
Yes.
Well, let me go to the food session. My name is Josiah.
Good morning, Josiah.
I want to ask our minister, what happened to Potakot Flour Mills Limited that was shut down under its watch? And as the main zone of the NAM, please, can you tell us what happened?
Potakot Flour Mills, Your Excellency, we'll check that because we have another call coming through here. Hello, good morning. Hello. Hello, good morning. Yes. Hello.
Hello, good morning, sir.
Yes, good morning. Your name and please, where are you calling from?
My name is Comrade Solomon. I'm calling from Port Harcourt.
Comrade Solomon, good morning.
Yes, sir. Let me greet, salute my Honorable Minister for Transportation. I don't know which you can. Sir, you are our Messiah today. Thank God you are back to River State. Sir, we have been suffering in River State. River State is the state of mess. Sir, we are happy that you're back to this state. Sir, we are asking you to employ every means that can bring struggle to River State people. We are suffering. What we are seeing in River State is not what we expected.
Solomon, ask the question.
Forget about whoever that has insulted you in any way. What we want here as people that were created by God in River State is peace. And we are begging His Excellency, whichever means you employ to restore peace in River State, sir, please, we are begging that you should restore peace in River State. Thank you very much,
Solomon. And we have one last call here. Hello, good morning. Hello.
You know, you make me forget
the flammy. No, the flammy.
No. Pension, flammy. Security again. Yes, we'll this
Hello,
is
good morning. Yeah, good morning, Shego.
Good morning.
Yeah, River State, good morning. Yes, please, what I want to ask...
Tell us your name, please. Tell us your name, please. What is your name?
Hello?
What is your name, sir?
My name is Bright Amewuli. I'm the chairman of Obiakpo Local Government Council and the President General of Grassroots Group Initiative Worldwide.
Okay, Bright, good morning.
I want to ask the governor. He says that no project was abandoned. What happened to Rumomoy psychiatric road, where his former chief of staff is from, and constructed that section of the road, and then constructed the section of Rumomoy Aziz, and said he was only going to do Rumomoy Road because that the PDP staunch member there. Is, was it fair to the people of River State? Because that road does not belong to PDP, nor does it belong to the Mumbai people. Secondly, is he aware that he has a face-off today with Parker, the former commissioner for health? Because Parker said, I cannot continue to take care of your mental illness because I'm not operating like a normal human being. And that you must be careful in insulting the governor of River State.
Bright Amaechi.
He has threatened the people of
Bright
River State.
Thank you so much.
Over River State with the military.
Bright Amaechi, thank you so much. Your Excellency, psychiatric Rumomoy Road.
No, that's how it's that, okay, that Parker said he's tired of treating my mental.
You don't have to answer all questions.
No, please. One good thing that God has done for me, and I'm forever grateful, is that I've never been a patient in any hospital. What I mean by I've never been a patient is being admitted. If I've been admitted, it was maybe once or twice as a child. If I've been admitted in any hospital as a child, I have never visited. Not even psychiatric hospital, Port Harcourt, visited as I'm passing by and I passed in. Even when Parker was living there, I never visited. Again, Parker is not a psychiatrist. Parker is a radiologist. My friend who is a psychiatrist is Dr. Inda, and Dr. Inda has never treated me of mental illness. So that should clear that, because these are rumors that Mrs. Goodlord Jonathan was carrying, that it's only people who take cocaine and heroin that can behave the way I'm behaving. When you are not fearful, when you are, for me, my life is about being honest. Once you're honest and you say the truth and you can speak truth to power, people see you as abnormal. They like, yes, sir. Yes, I'm not a yes, sir person. If it's a lie, it's a lie. If it's true, it's true. Now, he talked about Rumomoy Road. Yes. We were awarded the contract. Money was the problem. But they had commenced construction. But money was the problem. Now, it was because of PDP who stopped it. So let the governor is PDP now. Let him do it now. Let the governor please do it. So it couldn't have been because of PDP I wouldn't complete the road. It was just basically because there was no money. And the money, again, you've heard that I was accusing the President Gulojata of being corrupt. I hope you're following what's happening in Abuja. 2.1 billion, 6.1 billion. You heard what is happening. All these are things were the things I said by then. Now, what other question did he ask? He said, there's something he said I should tell River State.
You insult the governor too much. That's what he said. Yes.
please.
Okay,
let me answer the question of pensioners. I paid pension up to March. They left 5 billion naira for me as arrears before when I came in. I paid 5 billion naira and I paid them. I made sure now, instead of paying them yearly as they used to pay, they will leave them until the end of the year. I said they should pay them as if it was salary. Every month they should pay. I thought pensioners should be grateful to me. And I didn't like they come and queue up, and by the time you wake up, the next day, one person is dead. I said, no, pay into the accounts and pay them every month. I didn't do what others did. At the end of the year, they paid them something. No. Every month, all pensioners must sit at home and get their money. What we now call a lot.
The issue of the flour mills.
Well, that's correct. A governor won't do everything. The only thing that came to me about flour mills was the need to privatize it. And I didn't like the kind of amount of money they were bringing in to buy it. So I didn't sell it.
Recently, the River State government embarked on a biometric exercise for civil servants, BVN. And it was discovered that there were some illegal employment. In fact, there's a case, I think, Reef Poly, where they said some people were employed at the twilight of your administration. Are you aware of that?
It is also not true. Before I left office, a year before I left office, or 2 years before I left office, I had gone there and asked them, what is their problem? And they said they have no lecturers. You can't have a school without lecturers. So I asked them to employ lecturers. Instead of the governor to be grateful that I had that courage. Don't forget, when I came, salary was 2.5 billion, just like IGI was 2.5 billion. By the time I left office, salary was 9.2, because I had to employ, and they were not employed illegally. By the time I came, doctors were just 200. And doctors told me in a meeting, if you don't do something, we'll end up with 100 doctors because some people are going to retire. What did I do? I employed another 400 doctors. We got to 600. Doctors that were retiring, we engaged them as on contracts. How else? We are second in the country in terms of the number of doctors in the country. Some states, other countries had 100, 200 doctors. We had 600 to treat patients. I was visiting Braithwaite Memorial Hospital at 2 a.m., 3 a.m. When I see people lying on the floor, I say, who are these people? Oh, brothers or sisters to the patient. I say, the reason why they are here is because you nurses can't take care of their patients. When I came, nurses didn't have automatic employment. So we didn't have enough nurses. I got the School of Nursing to create automatic employment for all nursing students. Once they graduate, in fact, the moment you become a nursing student, you're automatically a staff of River State Government at level 8. So that you don't go when you graduate. Once you graduate, you go into the Ministry of Health. We are building behind us here the old UPTH, a 500 capacity school of nursing with hostels, classrooms, auditorium, staff quarters, and other. Unfortunately, we didn't finish it because we didn't have money. Oh, yeah.
Your Excellency, I hear you talk about the Justice Lamikara Iyaye. Who has been?
I've never talked about her.
Well, you criticize some issues, particularly here in River State, and I heard APC in a statement talking about 9 lawmakers approving Justice Lamikara Iyaye's appointments. What's your take on that?
Maybe she knows she's not a chief judge now. To be a chief judge, the State Assembly must approve. There's no State Assembly.
But the State Assembly has nine members. The quorum.
What is 1/3? The question says 1/3. What is 1/3 of 32? 12. So if you don't get 12, there's no assembly. Even she, as a judge, she knows she's not a judge. We'll finish that. We'll end that in court. She's not a chief judge. For you to be a chief judge, minimum of 12 members of the River State House of Assembly must be sitting. In fact, that 12 doesn't even include the speaker. But let's even, for purpose of argument, say, okay, include the speaker. For you to be, I was a speaker, don't forget.
Yes.
For you to approve a chief judge, the House must be sitting. The House sits only when there are 12 members of the House of Assembly. So 9 members cannot. Even Nyesom Wike knows. He knows that be, after the election, that'll be second battle. He knows. Unfortunately, he creates battles for himself. Because ordinarily, if they constitute the House, they could approve the chief judge for him. He doesn't know. But unfortunately, he did not.
Your Excellency, we just have about 10 minutes more.
I was wishing to go.
we just have, but I just want you to speak to River's people because a lot of people want to hear you. From what we are seeing so far from the social media and the telephone calls, and of course, you have said you will be around till
the 2019 election. I'll be here.
And so many comments are still pouring in from the social media. So you talk to River's people on what they should do at this moment.
First, let me thank them for the tenure, the period for which I served as governor. I had cooperation. I worked tirelessly. I never slept. I had difficulty sleeping because I needed to find solutions to problems. I focused on education because that will impact on the poor man, and we had social benefits in that. The social benefit is not cash. It is because people began to go to school and abandoned crime. And that's why we introduced free education. I introduced free health care. I built over 140 to 150 health centers. I employed over 400 medical doctors and posted 150 to rural areas to man those health centers. And I made sure it was free health care. You had the person who called from Rumibu. There's one in Rumibu where people were supposed to be going for free. I built the dental center for the patients to go, and again I made sure it was free. I built Kelsey Harrison Hospital and got foreigners to manage it, for which people were also being treated for free. Right? I built roads, including the road to Nyesom Wike's village, where his father's house is. I built that and increased the power electricity supply in River State. By the time we finished, we would have gotten to 715. If yes, we had allowed Sahara Energy to complete it, we would have gone to 715 megawatts. So, honestly, I thought I should behave like the proverbial Ikure redneck lizard who fell all the way from the top of an Iroko tree and then nodded his head. He looked right, nobody praised him. He looked left, nobody praised him. He nodded his head, I've tried. I think I have. So what do the people owe me? Not to listen to the governor who lies. I never lie to my people. One thing that comes naturally for me is honesty and truth. Everyone knows that. And that's what they call being brash. That's what they call being brash. That's what they call being arrogant. I'm not an arrogant person. My father wasn't a rich man, so I have no need to be arrogant. Absolutely have no reason to be arrogant. But I speak truth to power. And I spoke truth to President Goodluck Jonathan. I defended the interests of River State. As governor of River State, President Goodluck Jonathan had taken out the oil wells from Zikola or Suku to Bayelsa. And I fought that battle. Ask Nyesom Wike, he's been governor. Has he done anything? If I go back and fight it now, we'll get it back. He will benefit from it. I fought the battle in Akwa Ibom State, where I won it in the Supreme Court, where Abiu had taken our oil wells through stealing. And I fought that battle and I won that battle. And our interest was never defended. I fought with my blood to defend the River's interest. And when it was time to move to APC, I felt that River's people were not protected in PDP. And I went to APC. Today, River's people are beginning to reap the benefit of my moving to APC. We must thank God first. We must thank God. I had pastors and priests who prayed for me. Then I said in AIT yesterday, my priest will not pray for me a week.
Why?
Because he can't be supervising the mother of Nigerians. I never supervise the mother of Nigerians. My priest will tell me, I won't pray for you if you do the following things. You go to any pastor you want to go to. If he says it's a lie, he should go to my priest. He knows my priest. Everybody knows my priest. Father Steve Dedua, he should go and need that. He will not pray for him. Even though the Bible enjoins him to pray for the criminals. But I can tell you, beyond spirituality is also morality. Can't be watching people being killed. You can't help people. You can't help people to be killed, and then you can't need that before my priest. He will not. He will not.
Now, Your Excellency, concerning the
so they should go on Saturday, yes, 19th, and vote for APC. The reason they are shouting security. These are people who watch Nyesom Wike. They will tell him go and protect the lives of people. But if you give him a rubber stamp PDP assembly, then more persons will die. But if he has an opposition assembly, he 24 hours he's working. That's the way to deliver the dividends of democracy. So I implore River people to come out and be assured that there will be security that day and vote for APC. If I have done anything for River people, they should come out. They should not make governors feel sad for serving. I did the Rumasi road to what do you call it, near Siwa. I did that. I did the Rumasi Lekaiha Road. That's in Port Harcourt. I did the Mbogu Road. I started the Tasamadi Road. I did power. I got $180 million loan from World Bank to do water. Today they can't give Nyesom Wike the money. They are very worried. I've been begging them, give him the money if he can execute the contract. Please give him. It's the rivers people that want the water. Don't, because of the fact that there is a poor governor, don't give them the loan. By now, if not for Nyesom Wike and what's this man's name? Because he's Konjiwala. The contractors would have been on site even before we left office. But the same Nyesom Wike stopped the water. Can't even go. The people are even scared to give him the money because the level of corruption is high. What, $80 million to give the whole of Port Harcourt water? So that people will stop dying of waterborne diseases. I think I have tried, and I think the rivers people owe me that. And as a true rivers man and a true Ikwere man, I felt other rivers people should be given a shot at government house. The only way they can tell me thank you is to come out on the 19th and vote APC.
Your Excellency, the former governor of River State and the Minister of Transportation, thank you so much for coming on Viewpoint today. Thank you so much, I appreciate it. And that's it on Viewpoint this Saturday. And of course, the discussion will continue much more later. A big thanks to all those who've called and sending comments. And big thanks to every one of you. Good morning. My name is Shegun Olabi. Shegun Olabi.